couldn't fit a toothpick in his car. Mountain bikes up on top, two folding kayaks inside, hiking equipment, all the camping gear, we're chock full. Okay, it is a really foggy, rainy, drizzly day today up here in Bar Harbor, Maine. We're in Mount Desert Island, Acadia National Park, and this is the vestibule. People keep asking me, one of the more comments on my videos is, what is this? Who makes it? It's a vestibule, V-I-S-T-A-B-U-L-E, teardrop trailer, made by Minnesota Teardrop Trailers. It's you can see them at vestibule.com. The other question I get is, how much does it cost? And the cost is variable depending on what options you get. The only option I got was a lot of electricity, and I got this tongue box. You can get all sorts of cabinet configurations. You talk to Bert at Vestibule, they'll tell you what you need, what you want. Go with their recommendations, they know what they're doing. In my case, I paid extra. I got a tongue box, which is accessible from inside the trailer. That made a lot of sense to me when I was sitting at my desk, you know, at work, looking at a computer screen, thinking about this. They've since evolved. They have an external tongue box to replace this. It's much less expensive, has high volume, simple. Of course, you have to go outside the trailer to get it. They offer a number of different options, including air conditioning, heating. You know, those would probably eat up some of the cabinet space. I think the external tongue box is a good idea. It gives you extra room, adds a little weight to the tongue probably. Mine, I had to really argue. Well, I didn't have to argue, but I had to convince Bert to give it to me. He didn't want to do it. It's a lot of work. That's why he doesn't make them anymore. This might be the last trailer with an internal tongue box. They offer other options such as cabinetry. I don't know if they still offer the dishwasher, the inflatable pontoons, or the submersible package with the periscope. I think those, not offering those anymore. I didn't get them. Maybe I'm sorry I didn't. So when I was trailer shopping, I looked at the Campin 550. I didn't get to see a 560. I looked at the, which had like convertible sofa that changes into a bunk bed. I don't have kids, and I thought it might be good for storage. That would be nice. I looked at the Oregon Trailer online. Very nice hardware. You know, they're all well made, very nice. And I actually went and looked at some of these trailers. A little guy, checking them out. But when I saw this design, meaning that window and these windows, and I saw that the interior was just gobs of room for the size. On a regular trailer, like the galley would be up front, and this would drop down. There'd be a wall here that would cut off, kind of like an L shape for the humans. Your feet go under the galley, and your body goes up here. And the lack of windows made it not too attractive for me. I didn't like it at all. You know, some people love that, and they like that closed-in configuration, you know, that secure feeling psychologically, I guess. I like that open out, I want to see everything going on look. So this one really appealed to me. And of course, this changes into a bed, which was a big thing. I get two for one there. The storage, tons of storage. So I just fell in love with it and started saving as soon as I saw it. And the rest is history. So far, very happy. It is really a dank day, and I have 2 5-amp solar panels, and I just measured them. They can put out 5 amps in full sunlight. That's a lot, 100 watts each, 200 watts. That's a lot of juice. And I have a 55 amp hour battery. Now, today is really a very overcast day. I mean, the sky is just gray as could be. And not much view, it's foggy. I'm only putting out 1 amp an hour now. That's plenty for what I use. This trailer only uses 5 amps a day. I mean, a full tilt. If I have all the lights on and charging things, etc., that's what I have right now is plenty. I do plan on getting a refrigerator at some point, and that's why I got the extra power. I think this battery, which is 55 amp hour that came with the trailer, I could probably run. I haven't done it yet. I should try and run down the battery, see how many days I get out of it. I'll do that in the future if I have more time on this trip. We're in a campground with AC power. All I'm using is water. We're going to be up here for 10 days, 11 days, and not using any AC power other than for the waffle irons, which we brought from home. We just wanted to have waffles. But everything's working out really good. It's been windy. I do see some limitations with the REI alcove at 22 miles an hour. That's about where they max out on wind. We have a wind meter here. And much more than that, I'd have to take them down. I did remove the canopy from one and just left the frame up because it was getting pretty windy. Either that or you need some heavy-duty stakes. They're not meant for high wind. So if you're going to be in high wind and wind-driven rain, you're going to be dining in the vestibule. We had 22 mile an hour winds, so these suction cups worked out pretty good to hold down the panels. I had them on here with nothing, and one of them lifted off. You know, we had to pick it up off the ground. So the suction cups are holding down in 22 mile an hour winds, gusting, 22 mile an hour gusts. So. A 150 watt inverter, just a tiny one. Inverters are notoriously inefficient. They really require tons of energy to work. So the solar panels are working, everything's charging up just fine. Plugging this in, wait for the green light. I've got it. Plug in the electric shaver and I'm in business. Okay, for breakfast we have fresh onions and tomatoes, green tea, fresh made toast, jam, soft boiled eggs, fresh cherries, tomato, and also beautiful scenery. Well, I'm pretty much ready for 12 volt. I've got these Amazon 2-amp USB chargers. They're all over the trailer. I have, just plug them in and you can charge all your USB things. For the camera, I have this dual AC 12-volt charger, travel charger, off eBay somewhere. And you just flip out the prongs for AC. We do have AC at the campground, but we chose to go solar just to learn more. So, take this baby, plug them in, and insert battery. Let's see. Okay, there we go. Bar Harbor. Got the Okay, the wind's kicked up. We're getting 22 mile an hour gusts. I had to use extra tie outs on the alcove canopy. And you can see it's kind of bowing the size into the wind. Kayaking. We had great heavy-duty winds kayaking. We decided to come back in. Wonderful day. It rained like hell last night. We had a ton of rain. I was dry as a bone in the trailer. We had 22 mile an hour winds, so these suction cups worked out pretty good to hold down the panels. I had them on here with nothing, and one of them lifted off. You know, we had to pick it up off the ground. So the suction cups are holding down in 22 mile an hour winds, gusting, 22 mile an hour gusts. So. So the cup system worked out good. One for gear, two for clothing, bicycle clothing, kayak clothing, all that stuff. Life jackets and everything else are somewhere else. Same amount of tubs here. Easy to pack into the car, one tub for food. So they were a good deal, and they've been waterproof. We just leave them out in the rain, you know, under the alcove, and we can get our stuff and do it. Space is limited, and this works out good. So this is the only off-grid that we're doing, the only on-grid. We brought two waffle irons, and we're making waffles, and they're coming out really great. Where is this thing here? Yummy. Okay, these are silicone measuring cups. Cups and milliliters. Flexible, unbreakable, make them, it's like a spout. Multi-purpose. Here's a small one that does teaspoons, tablespoons, and what do they measure? Ounces and milliliters. So, same deal. Okay, nothing but nice things to say about these silicone pot holders, trivets, jar openers, and coaster. So I'm using them, you know, I have a pot lid that's hot. I can just put it on here. I can put pots on it and stuff. I just love these things. They were dirt cheap. And as a coaster, it holds quite a bit of liquid, which prevents it from spilling when you're in the trailer. That was a 1 ounce spill. And half of this thing. So, and it's holding it. So they clean really easy too. The best thing about them, I'll just take this and shake it. All the water will come off. And they don't get dirty like cloth pot holders. They're silicone. Cadillac Mountain. Okay, this is a $18 Coleman cooler. It's a 48 quart or 50 quart. I think it's 48. I covered it with Reflectix bubble wrap. I put two layers on top, one layer on the sides with a hot glue gun. Didn't take long at all. 15 minutes maybe with scissors. These small blocks are still ice after 5 days, which is incredible. Usually I get 3 days, so I think the Reflectix worked. I just purchased more block ice. And for $18, you can't beat this cooler. So one of the things that's helping is a thin piece of Reflectix. I just put this on top, and mainly it's to keep the cold down. It's really good when the cooler is half empty. It keeps the cold down, and you'll have a warm air gap above it. It's certainly easy to do. We're doing it.
And up straight there.
So where possible, we try and get multi-purpose items. And this, you know, Tupperware mug, nothing special there, comes with a lid that you can seal it tight. So if you bring it in a trailer, you don't have to worry if you knock it over or something. It is actually liquid tight. And then it has this other lid, which has a straw hole in it, and you can put that on, and when you're driving or in the trailer, it comes with a straw, you can have a sippy mug, a sippy cup, so you're gonna lessen your chances of spills. Okay, this is some lighter I found on eBay, and what I like about it, it has this extension. When you go to light the stove and things, it allows you to turn it over without burning your thumb. Relatively simple thing. It is refillable, but I bought so many of them, I don't have to ever refill it. They're very cheap. I forget what they call them on eBay, but they're great. Just a few words on garbage. We're using shopping bags on a table, on the CGI table. These work out really well. We prefer smaller garbage bags to bigger ones. And these are free. And we were kind of recycling them by using them as garbage bags. But I think I'm going to buy a box of these bags and use them. This is about the size we need. I think it's 15 by 11 or something. I got to measure them. Okay, here we are. It's raining out. We're in the vestibule. I've got the Wi-Fi going. And you are, how's the desk working out?
Very good, thank you.
You
good, my postcards.
You're comfortable?
Yes.
Happy?
Yes.
Vacation's going all right?
Yeah, how about you?
Okay, it's been raining on and off, and we're making dinner here, and we're making a Spanish rice pilaf, and we went into town and we bought some haddock, fish, and broccoli, and we're going to, we figure the rice will hold the heat after we make the rice, and then we can cook the fish and the broccoli and have it all hot at once, and we're going to attempt to eat it in the trailer. So we got the rice done, fish is in, cooking, and the broccoli is just starting to bubble. The rice is hanging in, and it's raining. We're using the center table. We have the rice pilaf, the haddock, and the broccoli. And I got the same, I'm using the side table. And I got a good view of the darkness here. And the food's hot, everything turned out good. We're going for it. stereo's on, windows open a crack, we're ventilated, life is good. Okay.
Which plate you want first? Here, move that bottle.
Okay.
I'll give you your plate first.
Okay. It's got to come through here without tipping.
I love this. This is great.
Hey, it fits right through the hook. Good. Okay, hold on. Okay, here comes seconds. This guy just makes it through that opening. Okay. All right, give me your plate.
Okay, here comes my plate. Be careful of those two bones on the end there.
Okay. Okay, here comes the second helping.
Okay. This is awesome.
Okay.
I love it.
Okay. So I've never used a center table to eat off of, and it actually works quite well. It's a good option. I've used it for like a computer table and other stuff. Side tables are great too. So, all in all, a win-win. I got a lot of room up here for stuff. Windows fogged up a bit. I turned on the fan. We have these front vent ports. The air is being sucked in through there and going out the top, and it's pulling out the moisture. It's still raining outside. And this is the wild gardens of Acadia Park. The Wild Gardens of Acadia Park. This is a birch bark wigwam, the original dome tent. Hmm.